and the size of any embassy we've built anywhere else. Now, why would we have such an interest in ancient Babylon? Now, isn't that extraordinary? And this Gilgamesh, who you talk about, who was recovered, what does the Bible, what does ancient literature, the Sumerian text and other literature say about him? It says he was a mighty man of old. Same language that's used in the book of Genesis. And it is my belief that the kind of biotechnology we're talking about now, it's my belief that it is too identical to just be a coincidence. That it could be the new body watcher mechanism, if you will, the Stargate, the portal, in the same way that the Amorite and Hebrew texts, as well as other ancient records, describe how essentially the daughters of men, the antediluvian women, these other creatures of the time, and plant life became, quote, fit extensions, pathways, portals, for the embodiment of ultra-terrestrial unknowns. In other words, given the right body, made up of blended species, according to these ancient records, this created the portal through which the gods could return, or could come, or rise from their places, in actual bodily form, not like these alien greys, so-called, come now, where they seem to be more amorphous, and they come through a slit in the fabric of reality, and they appear and disappear. We're talking about beings that walked on Earth, giants of superhuman status, who because of their power and their size, ruled ancient empires. That's the ancient record. And it was also the ancient record of the Bible until some of the books of the Bible were expunged.
Secondly, right, and I think that one of the things that is remarkable to me is that given the knowledge that has been accumulated, it's fascinating, isn't it, that the illuminated ones, the ones that are preparing the earth for their coming man of perdition, the guys that control all the great banking families, control either the Dead Sea Scrolls or the ancient artifacts, Tom, what I've found as a central theme is that this knowledge that these entities possess, that they share with mankind, it's only to get them to cooperate with their God-given authority as men created the image of God to release them. I asked the general one time, I said, sir, I said, why is it that these men are releasing these entities, which brings me, when we get in the second hour, we're going to talk about the, is it Ksetot?
Yes.
And the magic bands, because in the magic bands, the word magic is the definition that people use when they don't understand something. But there's literally scriptures that talk about God having not only bound specific angels, but also that these angels are talking in the Psalms even about breaking the bands
right,
that have kept them from messing with humans. So what I'm telling you is that when I've talked to men who, and I think, Tom, the only thing that, you know, I would probably be, say, more aware of is the fact that those who try and keep these things sealed when they come through the gates, okay, there are actual people out there, I mean, everybody from the Russians, the Chinese, everybody, when they find these things in a state of stasis or basically suspended animation, they want to strip the bands on their wrists and on their neck and on their ankles off, ankle bracelets, and they don't understand that it is the binding power of God that had his believers in past centuries and past eons to bind these things. And now everybody's out there on the false promise that basically it boils down to this, that if you help us, humans, we're going to make you gods. We're going to give you eternal life, and don't worry about standing before the God of heaven, because we've now become the gods of heaven. And I think, Tom, that's what's astonishing, because basically these things are playing in to mankind's ye shall be as gods. You know, that's exactly where they're at.
Well, and as I'm looking at the clock, I have the feeling that we're getting ready to go to the break. We didn't allow for the break at the bottom of the hour,
right,
so that we're going to pick this up probably in the second hour.
Yes, we will. So we'll get right back. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the Q Files. I'm Steve Quayle. This is Tom Horn, my guest. 9/9, September 9th, year is 2008. We'll be right back after station identification.